One of the downsides of using mods on the Starfield is that Steam achievements are disabled. Thankfully, a problem created by having mods can be overcome by installing a mod. Isn't it ironic, don't you think? Right now, that mod is Baka Achievement Enabler. We'll discuss its requirements, go over full installation instructions for Mod Organizer, and show how to check if it's working correctly. Hey everyone, it's Cal from Dirty Weasel, and we are going to talk about the Baka Achievement Enabler. You know, one of the things that a lot of people care about is Steam achievements. I'm not one of them, probably because I'm old and jaded and I don't really care that much. I've been using mods for so long that I just expect achievements not to work, but I can understand the desire to have it. One of the things I do care about is the annoying pop-up that you can see here every time I open the console. That annoys me greatly, because I need to be doing testing and opening a console on a regular basis to do different things is something I do quite often. And having a pop-up on the first time you open a console is annoying and I don't like it. So after a few requests, I did see that people wanted to see how to install the Baka Achievement Enabler inside of Mod Organizer and how it would work with the Steam overlay. Well, good news. I went ahead and did some testing and I got it to work relatively easily. Let me kind of show you what we're talking about here. Over on the Nexus, Baka Achievement Enabler for SFSE, also known as the Starfield Script Extender, is mod number 658, and you can see the link right there, and I will include it in the description of this video. Basically, how it works is in conjunction with the Starfield Script Extender, it uses a DLL file to enable this to happen instead of a normal ESP or ESL or any of the other ways of doing it. And I actually like this approach. I actually do like DLL mods that are enabled by the Starfield Script Extender and all script extenders in general. So basically the description is prevents achievements from being disabled with mods or when using the console. And a lot of mods are ASI mods and they require use of the console. Also removes the warning when opening the console for the first time in a session. Great, awesome. I would always encourage you to read all the instructions here, and basically it's going to tell you need the Starfield Script Extender, and I will show you how to install that as well. But if you go to the requirements, you can right click on Starfield Script Extender and open a new tab, and it will take you directly to the mod. And this is going to be our first step before we do anything else. The Starfield Script Extender is mod number 106. You can see the link up there. Also, I will include this in the description as well. It is done by Ian Pat, and he is a member of the Silverlock team. And they are currently making the Starfield Script Extender and making improvements, and they're developing it quite quickly. The instructions are at the bottom here. It is a manual installation. It cannot be installed through Mod Organizer whatsoever. This is a manual installation process, so we're going to do it manually. I'll show you how to do that. Go over to files, and you can see the Starfield Script Extender, the most recent version as of the 14th of September, is 0.1.2. This does not have any scripts installed at this time. It is simply a DLL loader, but we'll go through that. This is a manual download, so go ahead and click manual download and then put it somewhere on your desktop. When you open the archive, and here I'm using WinRAR, but you can use 7-zip to do the same thing, you'll see SFSE 012 inside, SRC, DLL, and EXE files. The two text files and the SRC are not needed for installation. Let's go and set that right over there, and we're gonna go over to our main directory for Starfield. Here we are in the main directory for Starfield. You can see it's under Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Starfield, and you have the starfield.exe. If you do not see the .exe, go ahead and click on View and Show File Name Extensions. I use Windows 11, but Windows 10 is about the same way. Make sure that's enabled so you can see the right place. You're going to take the .dll and the .exe out of the archive and drag them and drop them in. And that's all there is to it. SFSE is properly installed. This is not a full rundown of how SFSE works, but just remember, if you always want to see a full explanation of what it is and how it works and how to integrate it, You can always just see a video that I tagged up here, but basically you'll always need to run the game through the sfse_loader.exec to get any mods to work. Now we're going to jump over to Mod Organizer 2, and you can see I'm using the latest Beta 7 edition, and this is not a full tutorial on Mod Organizer 2 because I'm waiting for it to go into full release, but I have been testing with it. One of the good things about Mod Organizer 2, it will automatically detect if you have the Starfield Script Extender installed properly. If you go over to this dropdown on the right-hand side, you can see SFSE was automatically recognized. And every time you want to run the game through SFSE and Mod Organizer Manage Mods, you'll need to select SFSE and hit Run. As a general reminder, and I see this error quite a lot in questions on the Mod Organizer Discord, is regarding profiles. If you come over to this Profile tab, it is fourth from the left, Configure Profiles. You can see I already have three because I do a lot of testing, but I have my playthrough, my default, which is basically vanilla, and testing. We will be using testing today. But all of them, you'll see one thing in common. All of them have the final box, automatic archive invalidation, as being checked. You always want to make sure that's there if you wish to use any mods whatsoever. So always make sure that is checked. We're going to use the default settings for this for archive invalidation. If you want to know what that means, go over to your tools, to your any editor, and it will automatically generate the two files under archive, binvalidate older files equals one, and sresource data DIRS final equals blank in the Starfield custom.ini. So it will take care of that for you completely. So now we're all set up and ready to go ahead and grab the Baca Achievement Enabler. Back over on the Nexus, once again, mod number 658, Baca Achievement Enabler for SFSE. Once again, read the instructions. Go to the Files tab. You can now do a Mod Manager download. If your mod organizer is set up correctly, it will accept the download directly from the Nexus. But if you haven't got it quite set up right because you're still learning it, you may need to do a manual download, and we'll talk about that later. I'm going to switch my profile over to testing because that's the one I use most times for these sort of things. And you see, since I downloaded it through Mod Organizer, it is here in my Downloads tab. If you're having trouble with that, you can always grab it out of your downloads. You see, I downloaded it manually into the Baca Achievement Enabler. Have your download tab over on one side, Mod Organizer on another. Just drag it and drop it into your Downloads tab in Mod Organizer, and it automatically moved over. One of the things that a lot of people ask about is, do you install SKSE through Mod Organizer? And you do not at the current time because there's no scripts included. So there's nothing to see here. So Baca Achievement Enabler, you can either double click to install and it's going to give you manual, or you can drag it and drop it wherever you like it. You can see I can put it anywhere I want. Install right there. Baca Achievement Enabler, SFSE, that name is fine to me. Don't press OK. Let's start learning how to use Mod Organizer. So you're going to go ahead and click Manual. And you can see right at the top, this file is valid and it looks properly formatted because the data folder is right at the top. And inside you have SFSE, the plugin, and the Baca Achievement Enabler.dll. That is the plugin right there. This is properly formatted, so you can go ahead and press OK. And then press Activate. So when you double click on it, you can see the entire file tree and exactly how you installed it. SFE plugins, Baca Achievement Enabler.dll, and a meta.ini that is generated by Mod Organizer. Over here in the Data tab on the right hand side, if you click on that, you will now see SFSE, plugins, the Baca Achievement Enabler. I also have a couple other files in here from Classic Sprinting, but that is the file we're looking for. And that's the beauty of Mod Organizer, is it kind of virtually just does everything and gets it where it needs to go, instead of manually downloading it, and then you don't really know what folder to put it in because the way Starfield is currently configured by Bethesda. We've got the mod enabled. There are no plugins with this. So let's go ahead and end the game and we'll take a look at what we're needing to do. So SFSE, now run. Like I said, always run it through the Starfield Script Extender with the mod enabled. press run. Okay, welcome to my testing arena. This is very early on in the game when we first encounter Constellation. So we're going to go through and test a few things. We're going to hit the tilde key, which is the key just to the left of the one, and this will open our console. You notice there's no message there saying achievements will be disabled. So that is good. Test number one, check. Test number two, we're going to find out if the Steam overlay works correctly because we are interfering with Steam a bit. We hit Shift and Tab, and there's our Steam overlay. No problems whatsoever. Good, everything's working correctly, so there's no problems in game. Let's just get out of here by using our tilde key and pressing QQQ. And there we go. How do we make sure that the Bonk Achievement Enabler was actually working? Well, there's a couple different ways of doing it. We just did a test and we could see that it worked correctly, but let's try to find out a little bit more. If you go into your documents, and I keep mine on the same drive as my games folder, if you click on documents, go to My Games, Starfield, SFSE, see, we now have a new folder inside of our documents called SFSE. Click on that. Logs. You can see now the Bonk Achievement Enabler.log has been generated. If you open that up with a text file manager, or in my case, Notepad++, you'll see the time, 12:52:01, that's the time that we last opened the game, was only about 5 minutes ago from right now. You can see that the Bonk Achievement Enabler version 10400 was loaded. So that's good news. But wait, there's more. Over on sfse.txt, if we open that up with Notepad++, you'll see the plugin Bonk Achievement Enabler.dll loaded correctly, handle 1. Handle 1 means that it was the first mod loaded. And that's important because if you go back over to Mod Organizer 2, it is the first mod loaded in your Priorities tab on the left-hand side. So that's kind of how it works. So you can see that it was successfully loaded in both the Bonk Achievement log and the SFSE log, and it was correctly ordered via the Priority tab on the left-hand side of Mod Organizer. Now's the time I make an important note about any SFSE mod. Anytime there's a new version of Starfield released, and we just had one about a week ago, the Starfield script extender will need to be rebuilt to accommodate the new executable from the update. And any mod that relies on the Starfield script extender will need to be rebuilt as well. So just keep that in mind every time a new version of the game comes out. Your mods will not work correctly, and you will need to wait for them to be rebuilt. It's just one of those things that we have to go through until we get a mod later on that we got for Skyrim called the Address Library, and then it won't be that much of an issue. But for the time being, we are a far time away from getting any of those functionalities. So just remember, game update, SFSE update, mod update. That's the order, and then everything will go back to working correctly. So that's it. Bonk Achievement Enabler is all installed. You can see you had the Steam overlay. We got the correct messages, and we verified that it was loaded correctly through the Starfield script extender. So you're all set. If you have any problems, you can always contact me on my Discord, which is the link down in the description, or go to the Mod Organizer 2 Discord and ask questions there if you have any questions about Mod Organizer in general. My name's Cal, I'm from Dirty Weasel, and I'm signing off.